Here is the story with our mast and rigging. Back in the spring, when we still had the idea that we would be getting finished by the summer, we thought it was time, once all of the riggers were hopefully slowing down their work, to drop our mast, remove our rigging, bring it in, have them replace everything. We gave them the measurements with the old rigging, so it should have just been a quick job. And we figured it was something that would be done in about 2 to 3 weeks. We even had gone in with friends because we get a discount when you drop multiple masts at one time, and we told them, you know, like 2 to 3 weeks we'll be done. We could get both of our masts back up, save on the crane. But here's the problem. We told our rigger when we dropped it off last spring that we weren't quite in a rush, thinking that instead of having it within a week, as what I assume most people would... Freaking helicopters. When we dropped our rigging off in the spring at the beginning of what we thought would be the slow season, we told them not to rush. You know, instead of having to get it done in 7 to 10 days, as we assume most people hope for, we were thinking that the no rush meant 3 weeks, which we could handle. Bad idea. Here's a friendly tip. If you ever drop off your rigging and say no rush, they take that as, I'm gonna, you know, give it 9 months or so. So fast forward to Thanksgiving, when we finally got our rigging back. And again, we weren't in a really big rush. We wanted someone getting their mast up at the same time. One of the reasons we did want it to get done around Thanksgiving to the New Year is our friend Jamel, who spends half of his year working in Alaska and his other half cruising. He also works as a part-time rigger for one of the local companies, and we figured as long as he was around and we offered him a free lunch, he would help us raise our mast because he knows all of the lingo for the crane guy. He knows where everything goes, and I'm kind of useless in that department, unfortunately. So we really wanted his help, and we had a specific time frame before he left that we wanted to get everything done. So Matt was getting all of the rigging ready. He spent a few days getting all of the bolts back in place, the furler with the threadlock, running all of our halyards and lines. And for us, this is going to be a huge step in actually getting something completed on the boat, something visible, since it seems all the projects we're working on at the moment are just those kind of behind the scenes things that get covered up and you don't really get the sense of accomplishment. So getting the mast is going to be a big visible step towards getting back in the water and thinking that there is light at the end of this tunnel. But unfortunately, that did not happen. Once the crane came and everything was going smoothly, we had it attached, it was getting raised up on deck, smoothly in place. We thought it was going to be a big day for celebrating a great success finally on the boat. And as Matt had attached the forestay and was going to attach the backstays, as our friend Jamel was kind of just holding the mast in place until it was secure, he had me go attach the shrouds, and as I brought them out to the side, it wasn't coming close to fitting. There was about that much of a difference. It was short. There's no temporary fix we could do in the meantime. So unfortunately, the mast had to come back down and kind of had the crane come out for nothing, which we still had to pay him, unfortunately. Once we had everything down again, we took our old rigging, which we had luckily still saved, and spread it out next to what we had just gotten, which is something we should have done initially, but we kind of assumed that our rigger knew what they were doing when we dropped everything off and gave them very specific instructions. So once we laid everything out, we found out that half of the standing rigging was not to size, and it was nothing that we could even, you know, just kind of get by in the turnbuckles. It was something that it wasn't even going to reach. So that was the fun of that day. We had to contact them right away, explain the situation, and just hope that they would work with us in getting it fixed.
The only thing I don't like about it is you have to use a proprietary cable. That's the only thing I don't like.
This is supposed to be a celebratory lunch. It's no longer a celebratory lunch. We're kind of sad over here.
So I just came from the rigger. We sent him a few emails yesterday after we had the debacle of the mast going up and then having to come right back down again because our shrouds and backstay were a few inches too short. So luckily, he didn't ask any questions. He just said, you know, I'll make it right. And so since I was running errands today in the Palm Beach area, I brought it out to him, just kind of brought it in. And he came out, which was really nice of him, and said that he's going to get working on it right away. So hopefully he'll have that back to us within a few days. It kind of sucks that we lost our rigging friend that was going to help us put up the mast, but hopefully Matt and I can handle that ourselves. But it's good to know at least that they're taking responsibility for it and that they're working to fix it as fast as possible, because we were really, really excited to get our mast up yesterday, and it was quite a disappointment. Not only that we didn't get it up, but then we had the additional hassle to deal with because of that. So yeah, hopefully they get that work done right away. We can get the crane back out and get the mast up and actually feel like a sailboat again. Because we've had a few new projects pop up recently that have taken precedence, our work on the Hard Dodger has kind of taken a back seat recently. We've still been doing just a little bit of work on it. Matt has been working on the backside, fairing it a bit more and priming it. He had already done one coat of primer before, which has been sanded down to a smooth finish, and right now he's going through to add the second coat. But one other thing we've done is on the pads here, we've filled them in a little bit more with more epoxy and filler just to smooth them out and give them more strength. And then also in the extra support that adds the strength, Matt has also run conduit and built up a new pad so that in this spot here, we're going to have a light for the cockpit, and it's going to have a white light and red light, which will be really nice for us to have on passages. So that is about where we're at with the Hard Dodger now. And once we finish the backside, we'll be able to flip it over and work on the top, which isn't going to get as much work for the paint. Instead of doing a all-over smooth finish, we're just going to do the edges with a non-skid on the top. And here you can see it with the second coat of primer on. It's starting to look a lot nicer and closer to the finished product. So we'll just have to go through and give this another good sanding before we start getting on the final coats of paint, so we can start working on the other side and get ready to get it up. After having spent New Year's Eve alone in the boatyard last year, we wanted to start out 2017 right and managed to snag an invite onto our friends Cati and Johannes' catamaran in Fort Lauderdale once more. Due to restrictions on the U.S. cruising permit, we weren't able to take a late afternoon sail as we'd hoped, but had just as nice of a time enjoying a cold beer and catching up on what the other had been doing since our last get-together, all while enjoying that wistful feeling that swinging at anchor brings. And since my only contribution to our last gathering had been a pitiful plate of cheese and crackers, this time I needed to step up my game and busied myself in the galley making tuna salad cucumber bites. Look where we are again. Our friends Cati and Johannes came back from the Bahamas just in time to celebrate New Year's. We like to say it was for us, but actually they just had some boat things to take care of. So since they were in town for the holiday, we decided to take them up on their offer to come join them for the night, and we're just hanging out and about to go to the beach right now.
You'd be able to get all the stuff and be able to use that then as well, which is kind of the nice part about it, is it isn't.
Leave us, your people. then go to their party.
It's way too early tonight. Yeah. We have to wait until like 9 or 10.
So they've been drinking for a little while. Yeah. No, we're invited by the owner.
I know Scott. There's always a Scott.
Yeah. Arriving back to the boat, we still had a few hours to kill before midnight, so we had to see what kind of other trouble we could get ourselves into.
Kaiprenya.
Yeah!
And now.
With a little Russian in
there. I feel so bad that we made you roll the yard. Yeah.
And now Johannes is going to finish the bottle.
Yeah.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
Let's see how many other bottles you can finish off tonight.
Yes!
No.
All of them!
It's rum.
Rum.
Austrian rum.
Ooh, I need to try that. Let's see, what do we got here? Ooh. Stroh.
Why does it...
That is strong.
It's strong.
Does it taste like medicine?
It does. It tastes like very...
Yeah. Has
fermented cough medicine.
You get better with age, right?
I have to know what I'm drinking before.
Symphony.
Much better than you were at 20.
They're trying to trick me into drinking stuff that I don't even know what it is.
But apparently it's sweet. Oh, come on. You know things that you didn't know
at
20.
It's not
that. That tastes just like Robitussin.
Black fruit juice.
Like what?
What fruit juice.
Blackberry, you said?
Yeah, something.
Yeah, that's what it is. It doesn't taste very blackberry.
It almost tastes like a jam.
Yeah.
It tastes like Robitussin. You had to chase
it's
that
my
one?
Chase, I chase everything now. Oh. Well, when you have a big bottle of Moscato or Riesling, why wouldn't you?
You're like a professional drinker now.
Yeah. So what else do we have?
Can you start listening to craft
So basically
works?
I'm drinking like lighter fluid.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
But it's very famous in Italy. Drink it after dinner.
It's kind of festive. But my father used to go there. No, we were there with
foam party
with Johanna's parents and we also
her father listens to electronic music.
Yeah,
we need to hang out with both your parents.
Yeah.
Once we had tried almost every liquor on the boat, we settled on some more classic drinks such as beer and wine. We sat outside and enjoyed the nice breezes and all the boats passing under the bridge until we could finally count down until 12. Join us in our next episode, where Matt buries himself in the arduous work of wiring, and the welding is finally completed on our bottom, meaning we can start painting.